My friend, Nandan Nilekani, is one of India's best-known entrepreneurs. He led the creation of the world's largest biometric ID system. Now, he's working to promote his platform to improve the lives of the world's poorest people.
There are more than a billion people around the world who don't have any kind of ID. You can't do anything in life without an ID because people are mobile, they're migrant, and wherever they go, whether they want a job or whether they want to board a train or whether they want to get a bank account or get a mobile connection, if the person has no way of proving who they are, then they just won't get access to those services. So the challenge we had was, how do we give a billion people, many of whom don't have birth certificates, how do we give them an ID? Aadhaar is the world's largest digital ID system and entirely based using biometrics to ensure uniqueness. Our enrollment was very simple: name, address, date of birth, sex, email ID and phone number if you wish, and the biometrics, the 10 fingerprints of both the hands, the iris of both the eyes, and a photograph. And in a few days, he would get his Aadhaar number in the mail, and that's how a billion people got their IDs. You could use it when you're boarding a train or boarding an airline, if you want to open a bank account, or if you want to get a new mobile connection. You could use it to get your entitlements. All these things I would use the ID for. Let me talk about some of the opposition that the Aadhaar project faced. There was a huge argument on privacy. Cybersecurity, data breaches are important issues. All these debates have actually led to India putting in the checks and balances to ensure that it's used properly and wisely. So it's not data for companies to commercialize, it's not data for governments to do surveillance, but data in the hands of individuals to empower their own lives. In the developing countries, people will be data rich before they're economically well off. Therefore, can we think of empowering people with their own data? This is very, very critical for development because we have billions of people in emerging countries who have to be given a chance to participate and have access to opportunity. My view is that if everyone has a bank account, everyone has a mobile phone, and everyone has a digital ID, then they can do magic in their lives.